Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is J.E. on Hot New Hip Hop, and I'm about ready to break down country grammar. Check it out. Hey, what's up, everybody? This is J.E. I'm the producer behind Country Grammar. EI, ride with me, 90% of the album of Country Grammar. I did St. Lunatics, Nellyville, Pimp Juice, a lot of that record, Murphy Lee's record, Plies You, some stuff on 3-6 Mafia. I got a bunch of hits out there. So if you wanna go ahead and Google me, go ahead and do that, because the list goes on and on. So originally I started doing house parties in St. Louis, and there was this big skating rink called Saints that everybody wanted to spin at. And I had a friend that was DJing there, and he said, just come by, hang out, you know, maybe you can meet some people and they'll, you know, put you on, you know, you just hang out and just kind of get the vibe of everything. So I started hanging out, and back in the back there was this recording studio, and I figured if I was gonna be hanging around, I would hang around in the studio and kind of learn, you know, just the studio life, and to get something out of it, and just kind of, because I feel like I've always wanted to be in music, so it kind of intrigued me to be around people that were creating and making music. So after like about a year of just hanging around, just kind of learning, like watching how things are getting done, they were like, well, if you want to jump on the MPC when we're not having sessions, you go ahead, but there's sessions in here, you just play the wall. So I was like, okay, cool. So I started making beats. I was probably like on my third or fourth beat of just like trying to figure it all out. And the next session came in, and it was the Lunatics, before Lunatics blew up. And I was in the middle of sampling something. I forgot totally what it was. And they were, Ali from the St. Lunatics was like, man, I really like your beats or whatever. And he was in there with another producer, and I don't know if he was digging that person's, you know, beats or whatnot, but he was really digging on mine and was wanting to start the session with mine almost. But he ended up working with that rapper or that producer, and then we exchanged numbers, and then, you know, I kind of met Nelly, Murphy Lee, City, Kiwan, everybody, and we just started musically growing together as a musical family almost. And so I would make a beat, they would rap over it, whether it was good or bad, they would rap over it. And then I started learning how to do breakdowns, and you know, that's where all the doom, 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 doom came from, because I knew if I did that, they would do like some crazy dance move or whatever, you know, or take their vocals to another level. And so like it was, we would just play off each other. And so that's how I originally met Nelly. And then we did this song called Gimme What You Got, which was a big local hit, blew, you know, it was on the radio like nonstop. It was like number one within the day. So that's when I knew, like, okay, I'm gonna be a producer. And even then, whenever I was, when that came out, it said produced by DJ JE, because I thought I was gonna be like a Funkmaster Flex or a Kid Capri, because I never thought that I was gonna be a producer. So once it blew up and everybody loved that song, I was like, all right, cool, I'm just gonna be a producer and I'm gonna kind of follow this. But I'm still have my DJ, like DJ here and there. But and then after that, we ended up just started making more and more hits. And I think the first song that we ever did that was on Country Grammar was Batter Up. And so when Batter Up came out, that's why there was like Ali, Nelly, and then Murph, because it was still like the Lunatics. We thought it was gonna be a Lunatic album coming rather than a Nelly solo album. So once Nelly did that whole Fish Don't Fry, that kind of sing-songy stuff, that was like his lane then. That was what knocked it all out, like to where he started doing, like after that, I think we did Country Grammar and then Thicky Thick Girl and all those stuff, all those songs. So that was pretty much how I met Nelly. And then after that, you know, we got a deal, and actually we were up here shopping the deal with every record label, and I'm not lying, every record label, and they went from, you know, Def Jam to, I don't know, anybody, like, they all turned them down. And so there was this one guy at Universal who was just like, wow, this is amazing. And I think what it was back then, a lot of labels didn't know how to like market it because it was so new. And, you know, it just was at that time, hip hop was very like lyrical and, you know, it wasn't rugged. It wasn't about like, the sing-songy style or whatnot. And so Universal took that chance and, you know, like, man, and now it's at 10 million records sold. So I don't understand what the other record labels wasn't seeing, because I feel like those people should lose their job. You know what I mean? Like, how do you pass up a diamond record, you know? Because literally when we were shopping it, they Country Grammar was done, Ride With Me was done, Batter Up was done. Like, we were introducing this album as is, and everybody turned it down. So it's crazy. Yeah, turning down a diamond record. It's like, wow, you know, you suck at your job. When making Country Grammar, I was big into sampling back then. So I would take like break records and old soul records and even rap records, and I would just steal the snares and the hi-hats and the congos and stuff like any other rap producer would do back then. So I made a kit, and I think that the main thing that I started with was the drums, and it goes like this. So it's pretty simple, a little drum loop, and I just started with like a 4-bar loop, and then as time went on, I did the breakdowns. And I had no idea where this was gonna land. I didn't know if it was gonna be a local rapper or the St. Lunatics was gonna rap over it or whatever, you know, just like making beats freely. And so, that was pretty much all from other records, what you just heard. The siren was from, I'm not for sure where I got it from. It probably might have been on Sound Effects. Where is that at? Here it is, right here. So it's a siren. That's it right there. So that was just a siren that kind of just ended up making it in there. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it just was something, because I like the way I program the drums, but I always like to add some kind of weird element to it, whether it's like, I don't know, like a car horn or a siren or just even water. Just something to kind of make it melodic and just kind of different. I think that it just like the weirdness of it, of like, why would he use this sound? And at that time, like, I feel like a lot of producers were doing that. I think Timbaland used the baby sound at that time. There was just so much different elements going on in hip hop at that time, of just making beats out of just crazy sounds. So that was my crazy sound at that point. So yeah, I added the mallet in there first. It's really simple, it's only one note. I think it was like the D note, but it's just going up octaves, so doom, doom, doom. Just strictly, like, I didn't know how to play it back then, so it's kind of like, okay, that sounds good over that. So it was just like,
a lot of trial and error.
Yeah, it was just like I added that, and not knowing where this was going or whatever, just kind of just messing around. Then I just started stacking it, then I added these bells on top to fill in the gaps. And that's the same thing, octave. It was like three notes, three, three, and three. Just kept going up. And then it's funny, then the string that you barely hear, this was off Bobby Digital. I don't know if you, like, you probably have to go back and listen. I forgot what song it was on Bobby Digital's album, but I just constantly looped it. And so that was in the back. And even at the end of Country Grammar, I kind of freak it in the octaves. And so that signified the hook. Yeah, it's just, yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then I added the bass just to kind of make it bounce a little bit. that's pretty much what it was. And then like after that, I did little breakdowns. And then to be honest, like rewind it back a little bit, I did this beat and then my friend and I kind of rapped over it, and we weren't rappers by any means. At the time, we were just like kind of messing around. Because like I said, we didn't know where it was gonna go. So all the breakdowns that you hear were from actually this demo song that we did that I'm not gonna ever release, and it better not ever come out. But originally I had the breakdowns from that, and then I presented it to Nelly. And to be honest, all the St. Lunatics didn't like it. They were like, what is this? And it was so different from everything else that we were doing. And Nelly literally put it all together with the St. Lunatics and lyrically wise, and that turned into Country Grammar. And before it even came out, there was a kid on it, because it was, you know, the nursery rhyme type of thing. So they wanted a kid to actually sing the hook. And I think I actually have it on here. But we ended up taking it out and just kind of pitching Nelly up a little bit. If you listen to it, you hear the pitched up one in the background, and then his mane is in the front. But here it is with the kid. So yeah, that was the original.
Legendary.
Yeah. So the original was that, and then we took that out and then just put in, you know, had Nelly do it. So here's the hook. So yeah, that was it. And then, you know, at the beginning, I threw that little doom, 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 doom. And
I was about to ask you about that knock in the beginning.
It was just because I didn't want the beat to come straight in. I wanted something, and I've always been a fan of not having it just come straight in, even with like EI. It was just kind of that build up, and Ride With Me was just kind of the guitar, and then the beat kind of built up.
You and at that, to it.
Yeah, so I just kind of was like doom, 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 and then the siren. And then he filled in the whole like hot shit thing. And originally the song was called Hot Shit, but once we got to Universal, they were like, nah, we can't do that. So yeah, and then here's the
hot shit.
So yeah.